Dear students, I'm really happy once again. Really happy to be with you, meet you all over online. And today's class is for class 8. And we are discussing verbs and tenses. We will be discussing three main tenses today. The present simple, the present continuous and present perfect. And what we are going to focus today is the use of the tenses. We will be paying more attention to the usage rather than the formulas. When we talk about tenses, every tense is a formula. Formulas are important. But more important is how we use these tenses. What are the situations? You see, grammarians have a term, applied grammar. This is a term which all of us must know. All of us. And what do you mean by this applied grammar? You apply the tenses. That is very important. How do you apply? What are the contexts? What are the situations? That is very important. So, we start with a simple present today. And the easiest of the tenses, I would say, is the simple present. We have already discussed this. But to make you more aware of the uses of these, this particular tense, you need to kind of keep certain things in mind. For example, habits. Now, when you come to a classroom, you will have your friends. Not all friends are of the same nature. Some would be very talkative. Some would be very sober. Some would be very mischievous. Some would be very active. Some would be very slow in doing things. So, a classroom is a mixture of different kinds of students. So, each and every student of the class definitely has some habit. For example, your friend always tells lies. So you say, Roshan, who is my friend, always tells lies. There might be another friend of yours, Rohit, for example. He always comes late to the class. So Rohit always comes late to the class. There might be some who are very honest in the class. So Mohit is honest. So, to speak about the character or to speak about the habits of someone, you must always use the simple present. See, this is how we use. We don't learn tenses by heart. Learning tenses by heart will not help you reach anywhere. Memorizing the formulas, they're not going to help you anywhere. In any way, I'm sorry. So, learning the usage, understanding the situation, putting the correct tense in the right context is what matters. Habits. So somebody's habit, he always tells lies. He always comes to school in time. He always plays football after the school. He reads the newspaper daily. These are some of the habits. And habits can always be written in simple present. Then, a routine activity, we call this as a habitual action. Any habitual action can be written in simple present. For example, I come to school at 7:30 every day. This is a habit. This is your habitual action. I have my breakfast at 9 a.m. every day. I go to bed at 10 o'clock at night. I like visiting places. So all your habits, which you do on a daily basis, on a particular time, at a specific time, is expressed. All your habits are expressed in simple present tense. You see the formula is subject plus V1. He sings. Now you have to know the pronouns. Many students do not learn the pronouns. They do not know the person. The first person, the second person, the third person. First person singular, first person plural, second person singular, second person plural, third person singular and third person plural. You need to learn them. If you are not familiar with the pronouns, you will make a mistake in applying the right verb. For example, she, he, it. These three words are known as third person plural. Third person plural. And for third person singular, we use S or ES with the verb. For example, she studies. So you don't say she studied. It's definitely wrong English. So I add ES. He jumps. This is a fundamental rule. And many students forget to add S or ES when they use a verb with a third person singular. Any name comes under the category of third person singular. Any name. So with any name, for example, Roshan. Roshan sings well. Not Roshan sing well. Mohit paints well. Not Mohit paint well. Mary dances well. Not dance well. So keep this particular rule in mind. Keep this particular rule in mind. S or ES with the main verb. He, she, it. Or any name. And first person plural is we. You must know this. Second person plural is you. Mind you, second person plural and singular is the same. That is you. They, third person plural. So they sing, not they sings. We sing, not we sings. You sing, not you sings. But when it comes to the third person singular, remember, S or ES. He plays, he dances, he sings, he watches TV. He paints well. Yes or S with the third person singular. And remember, you must know the table of pronouns. I, we. You, you. He, she, it, they. Singular and plural. And how the verb affects the person, you must know that thoroughly. So, simple present is used to talk about habits. We all learn English in school. Something which is a fact. We can use a simple present to express facts. What do you mean by facts? Any statement which is true. We see the Taj Mahal in Agra. You go to Agra and you see the Taj Mahal. So, any fact is expressed in the simple present. Remember that. Universal truth. Scientific truth. Wood floats on water. Wood. Wood is it. That comes under the third person singular category. So wood floats on water. Mercury is a heavy metal. Silicon is nothing but sand. So all scientific truths are expressed in simple present tense. And then any kind of character is also expressed in simple present. For example, he's an honest man. Look at this. You have to remember, sometimes there might not be a main verb in a sentence. For example, he is honest. Now, what kind of tense is this? This is a present simple. But you don't have a main verb. So, in the place, in the absence of the main verb, a helping verb does the job. So, he is honest. We describe the character or quality of somebody. He never tells lies. Here, he never tells lies. Tells is a main verb. But in the sentence, he is honest, there is no main verb, but only the helping verb. Therefore, sometimes the simple present tense will not have a main verb. So, coming back once again, we use the simple present to talk about somebody's habits, routine activities, some facts. For example, grass is green. It is a fact. Milk is white. Coal is black. Gold is an expensive metal. Silver is used to make vessels, ornaments. So, you need to keep this in mind. Right? Now, we come to the continuous tense. Present continuous tense. What is the difference between simple present and the present continuous tense? The major difference is that the simple present tense is used on all these occasions for all these factors, but a present continuous tense is a tense which talks about something that is happening at the moment of speaking. That is a point to be noted. A present continuous tense is used to talk about an action that is going on at the time of speaking. The result is still felt. For example, I am teaching you right now, at the moment. You are listening to me. So that is what you are doing at the moment. So for any action that is happening at the time of speaking, for any action that happens at the time of speaking, at the moment of speaking, the present continuous is used. What is the formula? Look at the formula. We use a subject followed by is, am, or are plus V4. This is important. What is important? The form of the verb that is the present participle that is used. So what is a present participle? Again, I'm telling you, I've already told you this, but still, to put it in your mind, any verb form with ing is known as a present participle. Any form of verb having ing attached to it is known as a present participle. This is also known as V4. Remember this. So, all the V4 forms or all the participles are